exists because that is used, infrared rays are used for heat, heating. Ultraviolet rays cause damage. X-rays, gamma rays, these are all there. But then, this vibration frequency which is out of this, if things are vibrating at that frequency, we cannot see them. For us, they are invisible. So if the entity is vibrating at a higher frequency, out of our visual acuity, we can't see them. Similarly, we hear only a certain frequency. Anything above or below, we cannot see. You must have known about dogs. The hearing thing, the barking with the camera. We say, but the dogs, they can sense. Their visual, the hearing is of a vital higher range. So they can hear things which we can't.
Probably anyone can see extra.
That, not see, that is, see, that see is see their.
The presence of.
The sixth sense is much more developed in animals, which is not developed in us, because the moment we got intellect, that sixth sense was removed. But if you want the sixth sense, you can develop a sixth sense also, get back your sixth sense along with the intellect, and that will give you the higher powers which we call telepathy, teleportation. These are all within us. Remember, the subconscious is connected. Your subconscious is connected with the everybody, which is connected with the universal consciousness. So when they say some people, even though they are thousands of miles away, they can, if one person has something wrong, the other person can sense it. This is because of the strong bond which is a telepathy. And telepathy can be developed again. So when you work on your chakras and open your chakras, you open different areas of your brain. And the moment you open other areas of your brain, you get extrasensory powers. Human beings are marvelous animals, marvelous creatures, of great creation. We use only a very small fraction of our potential. Every person has got the capability of being like a God. In fact, within us resides God. The soul within us is a part of the universal soul. It is the only thing we have forgotten who we really are. If we remember our true self, what is it that we cannot do? We can do everything. Other questions?
Would we have to process to begin with, pull out some answers for any of our ailments? Then what are the major steps to follow?
See, many times we require a therapist or assistance to navigate.
Initially with that,
but see, I just told you a method of going into this subconscious. Now, if you close your eyes, you can follow and go to that living space. If you close your eyes, you can imagine the space which you had gone to. Suppose you want to meditate. What is the first thing of meditation? You have to close your eyes and move away from your surroundings. Because you are usually caught up with the daily matter. Mind cannot get still. So close your eyes and go to that living space. So, abhi yahan se chalega, ek problem khatam. Then over there are methods of healing where your body, we call it a body elemental, whichever part is in trouble, you can connect yourself to the cosmic, send that part for healing, bring it back here. So this is what we call pranic healing. So there are different methods of healing, which eventually are bifurcations of the same method. So there are so many, many methods, Reiki and all this which is there. It is basically energy healing in different forms. So, to find out the cause, you have to have an interaction. But to heal pains and problems, it is not difficult if you can get in touch with yourself. Maybe next time I will tell you more about what the essence of yoga is, what yoga means, what are chakras, how do we go about. So this is a different story, but that is the second step when you learn meditation. This will help you to live your life in a more empowered way. Not only your life, but help people around you to live it. It is a change. You are today because of what you have been doing till now. If you are happy like this, fine. If there are some issues, you have to do something differently to get rid of the issue. All issues are here. Everybody has got some issues. And usually the issues are with the family. Because you spend most of the time with your family. Somebody outside, you don't meet. If you talk about family, you have to meet. You are going to stay with them. You have to live with them. Issues are there with your children, your spouses, your parents, grandparents, brothers, sisters. Every house has an issue. But within that issue, if you can live without reacting, with forgiveness, love, happiness and kindness, heaven, which is there, you can create over here. Choice is yours. How you want to live? That is nobody else's.
Do you think heaven is just an imagination?
Is it everything an imagination? When we say that this itself is an imagination, it is Maya. It is an illusion. So, is that real or is this real? You are only confined by your thoughts. Your thoughts confine you. Otherwise, you are capable of it. Any questions? It doesn't matter what you say. It matters what another person feels who has departed.
Soul's will.
It's the soul's will. You may say everything good, but that soul says, I have got 100 crores. I will not leave my 100 crores. You may say anything you feel like, I don't want to leave. It's too much attached to his property and his money. He will not go. But if he is willing to go, and people who were there talking, अच्छा बुढ़ा मर गया, बहुत दर्द किया था इसी ने, आपस में, इस बीच में अच्छा मर गया, आपने देखो दर्द क्या होता है,
बढ़िया
था, see it is his will. What happens now is if you really look at it realistically, we have the चौथा ceremony in the मंदिर गुरुद्वारा से from 3 to 4. In the afternoon usually. When do people reach? 3:45. Right? And they will go in and then they will pick up the phone and say hello, hello and move out. Phone is not ringing. Shakal dikhani chale. Nobody has any thought. It is because of this. Soul is no longer not seeing everything. He is the governor, this is like an invigilator, seeing what is happening, knowing doodh ka doodh and pani ka pani.
Soul can't do anything
at that time. Soul can't do anything at that time. He can't do, but he has got the free will whether he wants to go or doesn't
want to go. That is true.
That is not your choice. Huh? So you will stay there and you will go and attach to someone. And from there you will go somewhere else. See, these are problem because most of the people nowadays carry attachments on their four parents who are possible. Either they don't want them to go. You're thinking, my mother has gone away, what will I do? I cannot live without her. The mother says, yes, yes, my daughter cannot live without me. Mother daughter stay together, very happy. And then the daughter starts behaving like the mother. After some time.
She starts
behaving like the mother. Have you not noticed? Maa ka yasa bol rahi hai, maa ka yasa kar rahi hai. It's very normal in their house. And after some time, getting the diseases of the mother. Mother had a chronic back pain, you also start having a back pain. And then even many times in the session, when we say, okay, send your mother away, you say, no, I don't want to send my mother away. My mother is there. How can I send her away? I'm so happy to have her with me. So, okay, keep her there. Keep her, you keep your pain also. That is what I said. Your destiny is your destiny. When in your body, apart from your soul, nobody has been. However near and near. Mother has a different destiny, a different soul. She has her own journey. We don't let the people go. You will see many people whose parents or husband or wife have gone and they will keep all their clothes, all their stuff like that in the house. That means they have not let that person go and that husband is there with the wife. So he cannot throw his stuff away.
So it should be thrown away, all that
things
belong to them.
Eventually the person is gone. If you keep all this stuff, he will also stay. So you are not going to be hampering yourself, you are hampering him also. That is what we call attachment. So the attachment is with things, with people, self. You came alone to this world. You will go alone from this world. But once we come over here, we start thinking it is mine. Main, mera, sab kuch main. Suppose I take you to a past life. And in the past life you will see, immediate past life, that you are a very, very rich person. With crores and crores of rupees. And you remember everything. This is my house, this is my property, here is where I kept my money. So you wake up and you say, okay, I remember everything, I'll let me go there and claim my property. You go there and say, this belongs to me. See how they will kick you out. Because the moment you die, everything goes. So even though you remember it is yours. Children always remember. When children are born, remember, a child has got a free will to leave the body and go till the age of 2 years. So that is what in our medical term we call SIDS, sudden infant death syndrome, where small children die suddenly, there's no cause. It is the soul's wish. So till the age of 2 years, you will see children playing and laughing and being happy for no reason.
Apne mein baat karte. I'm talking of a girl who's 4 or 5 years old.
Sometimes this memory remains for a little. In flashes they remember up to the age of 7 years. In flashes. Till their own consciousness becomes so strong. That is subconscious growth.
And 2-3 times she said things which actually happened, like Beyonce Singh's death in Polo Ground in Pudyala. She was coming from school with her mother. And she said, why the people have collected here? And she said, there is some critical function going on. Bomb is going to explode here, she said. And it really did. And she gave her a tight slap.
See, why do you slap? When we don't understand, what is a miracle? Miracle, what is magic? For which we do not have a logical explanation. We call it a miracle. Once we have an explanation, it becomes science.
And she said her father has had an accident. She was with her mother and he actually went with an accident.
So subconscious is connected.
And that girl was, wouldn't it be telepathy?
It is telepathy. See, actually whatever is there is all planned. We also, the time which is there is a word which has been coined by humans. Because time for us is linear. We are born, we will die. So that determines time. But if you are not going to die, so what importance does time have to you? आज नहीं कल कर लेंगे नहीं करेंगे साल बाद करेंगे दस साल बाद करेंगे सौ साल बाद करेंगे दस दो बिकॉज इट इज बीन डिवाइडेड इट इज लिनियर एक्चुअली टाइम इज नॉट लिनियर टाइम डजंट एग्जिस्ट सो व्हेन दे से कि दिस इज गोइंग टू हैपन इट इज अ सर्कुलर इवेंट व्हिच टेक्स प्लेस अगेन सी इफ यू स्टार्ट टॉकिंग इट बिकम्स मोर एंड मोर कॉम्प्लिकेटेड I have given you a very, let's say, brief and an easy way to look at things, a new perspective. Everything which I have talked has got multi dimensions. But then it becomes so complicated that it goes beyond understanding.
You're supposed to talk about being from the other world.
Okay, I'll talk a little bit, but not much. So when we talked about aliens, though I have not seen aliens, but yes, I have encountered aliens.
Encountered.
See what happened, I will be just telling you about one of the client sessions, who the client was psychiatric, like she was in a mental asylum. Her mother had come to me for sessions, and after few sessions when she was suffering from claustrophobia. She just mentioned that my daughter is psychiatric, she had a psychiatric attack, she's an asylum. Can you do anything for her? I said, I don't know. She can come and see. But I asked her, possibly she will not come, but she was supposed to be leaving. So she just told her, would you like to go? The girl said, yes, I'll go. And they brought her. She was actually not psychiatric. But what she had experienced, they thought that she had come back. So when I took her into a session, she had an encounter with aliens. Aliens. And she was taken by aliens onto a ship. And through her, I talked to the aliens. Okay. So then I asked them a lot of questions, they told me a lot of things. I asked them about, at that time we had this MH370, the plane which disappeared. And still nobody knows where it happened. So then they told me explanation which even I could not understand. And this girl who was there was not very educated. So it was not that she could have told me this or made up these things. She told me about linear time and circular time. And how things interact, how planets work, through those things. So even if she was cooking up this story, it is not possible for her. She described those people, those aliens told me their names, why they had come, how things move, how spacecrafts work, lot of things. And then they said, they told me that there are a lot of aliens on Earth who keep coming. It is only thing that these things are not revealed to you.
These things are not?
Revealed to you. They are kept hidden by the governments. There is already trade within different planets. Interaction is there. But we are told only what we are supposed to know. For example, let me tell you, when was a diesel engine invented? More than 100 years back. So you believe, can you believe that in 100 years we could not invent anything else? Abhi tak we are still using diesel and petrol. Everything has been invented and discovered, but they will not tell us because of the implications. If some other fuel comes, the Middle East will again become a desert. The major oil is there with Russia and America. If teleportation becomes available, so 1, 2, 3 and you are in America. So if you can go and come, where will the countries be then? Where will the borders be? If there are no borders, what will they defend?
This is called
teleportation.
Teleportation.
This is there in Mind Guru Nanak Sahib.
When he was there,
see,
his sister remembered.
Yeah.
With teleportation, he reached there.
It is there, you can also do it. If you have those evolved people, knew how to do it. But teleportation as a mean of transportation is also discovered. See, you have seen it in English movies, Star Trek and all that. When these things have already been discovered, there will be no borders. If there are no borders, what will you defend? No ammunition, no transport required. See how the world goes toxic.
But it is no human being can materialize and dematerialize.
Yes. Yet, so that you don't do, again there are things which have been done so that you can't do it. See, there are a lot of theories. You are into meditation, so you know the importance of the pineal gland. Pineal gland. That is the one which is connected with this. The entire higher powers reside over there. So these are different things, but now the time has come where in the next decade, 10, 15 years, the entire world is going to change. What it has not changed in the last 100 years or a few thousand years will change in the next 10 years. Just think 20 years back, 15 years back, people used to go to mandirs and religious speakers. Now you will see so many people speaking about spirituality. Spirituality, not religion, spirituality. Religion is a choice. If you want, you can change your religion. Religion is a way of living. It is how you live, so that you can live comfortably as a good human being in society by following few norms. See, every religion tells you the few basic tenets. Be good, don't tell lies, help others, respect elders, be kind. You see the Guru Granth Sahib, you see the Bible, you see the Quran, you see the Gita. Everything is about good. No religion teaches you to be bad. There are people who change the religion from Christians, they become Buddhists, from Hindus, they become Buddhists, from Buddhists, they become Muslims. Everybody can change. It is your choice. Spirituality is above everything. It is universal. It is what all religions speak. Spirituality is not limited to religion. When you are talking about spirituality, you are encompassing all religions. There is no such thing that my religion is good, your religion is bad. Religion is made by a group of people. group of wise people, someone who we consider as the wisest one amongst us, who we believe that he is thinking about welfare of all of us. And what the way he has said, even if we don't understand, we should follow. Which is very good. You do not have to have an intellect level to understand everything. You have to learn to believe. Bachche hain, parents, when they say, even if they don't understand, they obey them. Because they tell them things for their own benefit. Similarly, we obey our elders. Similarly, we obey our gurus. Similarly, we obey those whom we call God. So who is God? Who has created us? Something has created us, so we call that something as God. But who has created God? We have created God. We know there is something who has created us. So we have to give it a name. Jo marji naam de. Nomenclature. Either you call the person God, or you call the person the Messiah of God, or you call him the Son of God, or you call him the person of God, call him next to God. Anyone who we want to hold in a higher regard is given a place to fight. When you fight, and we all fight, that my religion is better than your religion, is when we really do not understand what our gurus are telling us. Because they only preach love. They preach only kindness. They tell us to do things which we have to do so that we live a life in a better way. They are enlightened beings because their sixth sense is open. They can understand and see people. You read any book, you follow any religion, you will see the essence of all religions.
They have been corrupted also.
That is interpretation. That is interpretation. People who think that they are the guardians of the religion will interpret religion as per their wishes.
Yes.
What is being taught is fear of God. If you don't do this, you will burn in hell. There is no such thing. God only believes in loves. A father loves the child. If you don't listen to him, he is not going to roast you in oil. He will still love you. The child does wrong, even then the father loves him. Similarly, understand, whenever we worship, it is very good to worship, because worship is basically being with yourself, connecting with yourself, connecting with your inner self, and understanding your inner self. Things are not different, they all move to the same essence. It is only using that essence to help yourself to live life and get happiness. The moment you move out of this, your body is not in harmony. The moment you are out of harmony, you get disease. Life is very simple, and life is very beautiful. If you believe it is so, it will be like this. Because it is all thoughts. Any other questions?
So is it positive feeling that does the trick?
If you think you are caught in the web, positive and negative are both our interpretation.
Relative terms.
Best is not Prithvi.
Thoughtless.
That is meditation. Thoughtless is meditation. Just enjoy. Enjoy the now. Thank you.